Good afternoon to all respected audience. India is a highly progressive economy with a vision of taking over major development nations. In the times to come, thanks to the digital disruption that is taking place through digital transformation across domain of operations, the Digital India mission of Government of India is a flagship mission to celebrate our success in adopting technology in our mainstream ecosystem, in our day-to-day lives. It is said that future lies in digital transformation. More importantly, it has comfortability and ease to offer to the citizens, the Digital India program of Government of India is intended to make life simple for citizens. Though government services delivered at home and delivered to the last mile individual, today people do not need to visit government office for any their rightful services that government offers for any of its citizen center services. Almost every government agency has successfully rolled out their offerings in digital platform, making it available at fingertips of citizens. The motto being Power to Empower Digital India campaign is made highly successful by connecting rural areas with high-speed internet connectivity across the nation. Needless to say, the campaign has enacted as a key beneficiary for other government schemes such as BharatNet, Make in India, Startup India, and Stand Up India in industrial corridors, Bharatmala, Sagarmala, dedicated freight corridor, Udan, RCS, and E-Kranti, and others. When the campaign was conceptualized, a careful thought was given on the country's specific need for digital transformation, intending for an overall makeover of e-governance served across corner of the country. The campaign runs under 9 prominent pillars, including broadband highways, public internet access, mobile connectivity, e-governance, e-kranti, information for all, electronic manufacturing, IT for jobs, and early harvest programs. As of 31st December 2018, India had a population of 130 crore, 1.3 billion, 133 crore, that is 1.23 billion Aadhaar digital biometric identity cards, 121 crore mobile phones, 44.6 crore smartphones, 56 crores internet users, up from 481 million people, that is 35% of country's total population in December 2017, and 51% growth in e-commerce, indicating the nation's progressiveness. The BharatNet project, which is the custodian of Digital India campaign, is monitored and executed by BBNL, which is GOI entity. Many notable offerings have been catered under the campaign since its inception, namely National E-Governance Plan, that is mygov.in, Umang, Unified Mobile Application for New Age Governance, e-sign framework, e-hospital application, digital attendance, black money eradication, and others. Umang, among all this, has gained prominence being a single, unified, secure, multi-channel, multi-platform. You can see it also one window clearance, multilingual, multi-service, freeware mobile app for accessing over 1,200 central and state government services in multiple. Indian language over Android, iOS, Windows, and USSD devices, including services such as Aadhaar, DigiLocker, bill payment system, PAN, EPFO services, PMKVY services, AICT, ECBSE, and many others. A concept developed to ease people's life of government services, hassless and converted to the digital platform. In a bid to enhance the back-end digitalization, the Digital India campaign has enabled eradication of black money, which is one of the prime root of corruption within our nation's ecosystem. The 2016 Union Budget of India announced 11 technology initiatives, including the use of data analytics to nab tax evaders, creating a substantial opportunity for IT companies to build out the system that will be required. Digital Literacy Mission will cover 6 core rural house stand. It is planned to connect 550 farmers market in the country through the use of technology. Today, newer technology concepts like artificial intelligence, internet of everything, blockchain, robotics process automation, and several other technologies are gaining momentum in developing the nation into a knowledge-based experience economy. The best part of formulating such interesting campaigns and policies is that the citizens are much receptive to the technology advancements that are happening in the country in a rapid phase. The Digital India campaign of Government of India is more an experience that citizens would relish on than any policy intended to smoothen their day-to-day life. Our progress, not limited to policy framework, is also to ensure increment of our capability in volumes in gradual strides. A recent such framework to fall in place is 5G spectrum. Trials are soon to announce in India of 5G network under careful vigilance and corrections of any hazards implying. The growth of the digital economy has meant the use of data as critical means of communication between persons, creating a collective culture that fosters a free and fair digital economy. Respecting the informational privacy of individuals and ensuring empowerment, progress, and innovation, in order to protect the autonomy of individuals in relation with their personal data, specifying the flow and usage of personal data in apt level, thus creating a relationship of trust between persons and entities processing their personal data. The MEITY, Government of India, is soon to introduce Data Protection Bill to safeguard crucial information from threats and misuse. Under the Pradhan Mantri Gramin Digital Saksharta Abhiyan, that is popularly known as PMG Disha, that envisages making one individual digital literate in every rural household. We have embarked on an ambitious journey of training around 6 crore people in rural area. The program was started in February 2017 with an outlay of 2,351.38 crores. However, the allotted fund would be sufficient to train only 2.39 crore beneficiaries. The required funds are also expected to be allotted in the upcoming budget. According to sources, the funds so far allotted for the digital literacy program includes 100 crore for 2017-18, 436 crore for 2018-19, and 400 crore for 2019-20. We are going one step ahead from Digital Transformation Initiative to Digital India 2, prepared by our ministry, MEITY, that is Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, that sets goal for the next 5 years. The implementing agency for the PMG Disha is Common Service Center, E-Governance Services India, CSC, SPV, and the target is digital literacy training on IT and applications, including digital payments. We have enrolled 636 training partners. There is rush for us to quickly train as many as people as possible so that the scope of mobile-based services and apps can be utilized to maximum. The government in the last 5 years has launched various schemes and projects as part of Digital India program. Now, in Digital India 2, it has to maximize the reach of these schemes so that the last mile citizen can access them at one's doorstep. The government has also prepared a draft 100 days action plan that includes National Policy on Electronics 2019, new schemes to the cabinet, National Policy on Software Products 2019, launch of registry, Digital India Infoway, National Government and National Knowledge Network 2, National Mission for Natural Language Translation, proposal to cabinet to overcome barriers across major Indian languages, and personal data protection bill to cabinet. Our ministry, the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, holds supreme and long-term vision, including supreme growth and development of India for knowledge-based economy for the next 5 years. Digital India campaign is that policy which intend to release mindsets from the shackles of conservative thought through right knowledge. In times to come, MEITY has several initiatives in pipeline to benefit of our citizens and developing India into a progressive economy. With this, I wish the 5th Digital India Summit and awards all the success. I look forward to receive the recommendations that are drawn out of the deliberations and exchange of information from all the stakeholders. With this, I thank you all of you and with best wishes.